What's going on, guys? Hope everyone had an amazing October. If you guys are watching this in the future on YouTube, be sure to smash that subscribe button and throw me a like. Be greatly appreciated. I know it's been a long time, guys. I haven't been on all of October. I think even the last week of September, I haven't been on, but I'm back. We did a ton of stuff off stream. I had like two or three photo shoots I had to do, and I have been living in Photoshop religiously for the last month and a half. So some very, very long hours. I think on average I was spending what must have been 10 to like 15 hours a day in Photoshop or Adobe Premiere. So I'm just happy to be back to working on the Armsy, prepping for the rest of the holiday season. So we're going to get right into it. And yeah, like I said, if you're watching in the future and you want to catch the live streams, jump over to Twitch. Links to my Twitch stream will be in the info for this video if you're watching this on YouTube. So let's do this. You guys may or may not remember, I had to reset everything up because I was shooting with a lot of my cameras that I use for streaming. So unfortunately, I had to strike everything and reset it up, and that was really unfortunate. So, but we're back to working on this guy. So, and yeah, so we're working on the arms. Yeah, there you go. We got to finish this these legs up so we can mold them. God, it's gonna be so weird sculpting. I haven't sculpted in over a month. It's crazy. Yo, what's up? You just resubscribed. Milo, how's it going? How have things been? Why are my stupid alerts not working? Long time no chat, Milo. How are things going? Man, that's the one thing I didn't test was my alerts. How you doing? I'm tired. You're working a lot? That's what I've been doing. Hold on, we're gonna test something out here. I've been doing Photoshop like crazy. I've just been living in it. I'm happy it's done for now. What have you been working on? You been doing any sculpting? You're trying to buy a farm. That's pretty cool. It's gallery. Wait, go my overlays. Stream offline, social overlays, streams and alerts. Edit. We're gonna try something. What kind of farm? How big? What kind of, like a cow farm or? Emulate. Let's do subscriber. Thank you for the subscribe too. Either way, Milo. Let's try one. Huh. Okay, that worked. That worked. I don't know what's going on. That's weird. I have to do a little bit more research into that later. I'm almost done with my commission. Nice. Renovations are almost done to your building. Awesome. What kind of renovations were you working on? Just like normal stuff like painting and whatnot. I don't know what's going on with that. That's going to bug me. I haven't touched this thing in so long, guys. Have I forgotten how to sculpt? And sculpting tools out of here. God, I so don't remember where I was at. Okay, I think I remember now. cow. Oh, for cows. Okay. That's cool. All right, there we go. There we go.
World Express elevator to hell. Going down.
Have you done farming before, Milo, or is this like a new experience? Ow. What up, Legdow? How's it going? Long time no chat. And look at that. Just like usual, my sound alerts aren't working, even though I tested them earlier. Sound alerts, monitor and output, close. Why do the gods smite me so? My alerts, elevator to hell, channel points.
World Express elevator to hell, going down.
There we go. Only fitting, right? Long time objective. I don't know. Maybe it's because I grew up around so many farms. I'm not interested in ever owning or working on a farm. BRB for sure. Yeah, I grew up around all that fucking cow manure and shit. But hey, to each their own, you know? Who am I to yuck anyone's yums? There's a better way for me to hold this damn thing. It was a toss-up between working on this tonight or starting to build the walls for the other limbs for mold making, but figured I should probably, you know, maybe finish the damn sculpture before I start making molds, so. Oh no, I don't disagree. We totally need farmers. I'm just not one of them. Like I said, I grew up around that and I've been there, done that. I'm one in my mind since forever, but one day I'll get there. Hell yeah. How many cows do you want? My wife would probably love a farm. You know, I could probably get behind a farm, I guess, if I didn't have to do any farming. As silly as that is. Rotive pasture? I'm not familiar with what that is. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what rotive pastures are. I feel like easy farming is an oxymoron, though. Like, isn't all farming, kind of difficult? So no manure mangling. Gotcha. No building repairs. Oh, the cows are always outside. Oh, okay. I think I get you. I think, what do we call that? Is it like free reign? Free range farming? Kind of like that kind of thing? Holistic grazing management, gotcha. 2 to 4 times a day. Oh, okay. So when buying a farm, do you get to buy the cows with the farm, or do you just buy the farm and then you have to get all your own cows? How does that work? Think about that. I could do this. Depends on the deal. Oh, I mean, that makes sense. Soil's productivity. Oh wow, okay. So when you're saying you're looking into buying a farm, like how far are you into the whole deal right now? Like, have you entered negotiations with any potential sellers or not yet? At the really beginning. Oh, you just saw one was for sale. Okay, nice. Yeah, the only thing I've been thinking about buying lately is this, the new Sony camera. Doing everything in my power to not blow all that money. Welcome back to the world's longest sculpt. Very, very, very true. It's very true. Because I'm not there yet, we meet the owner to ask if he was willing to do a session instead of a sale. What does that mean, Milo? What does that mean? Is that like a rent, what's it called? A lease to own kind of thing or what? It was a great talk, but he wanted to sell. Oh, I see what you're saying. Okay. Oh, okay. Huh, that'd be cool. But you said he doesn't want to do that. He just wants to sell it. And he knows at that price, the farm will need a miracle to make even $1 profit. Yeah. The world has not been very kind. I should say the economy hasn't been that kind to farmers as of recent history. So. Probably why he wants to sell it. That's true. You're not really growing a lot during those freezing winter months. That's very true. A farmer portress. Hey, there you go. That's what's up. I don't even own a farm and we already have a ton of animals at my house, man. So I think that's the only thing about a farm I'd be interested in, man. I would have goats. I would for sure have goats. That would happen. Ideally, the goats that scream, though. One screaming goats. Yeah, right. There's just some cool looking fucking goats out there too. Their goats' eyes are so fucking cool looking. Probably have some big fucking lizards too, you know? If you got a farm, you got space. Probably not if you have a farm in Canada. Lizards probably wouldn't do too well in that situation, but. Are cool too. Well, not all breed of cows, but Highland cows, mostly the only one that can stand our winter, are also cool cows. Are these like, did you already say, are these, would these be like dairy cows or meat cows, beef?
Need it like a vibe.
Gonna lurk for a bit. Just got home from Arkansas after 2 weeks. Nice. And spending time with the girlfriend. Gotta do what you gotta do, dude. So, ooh, fiance. Dude. I proposed and it's a habit. Congrats on the proposal. Congrats, man. Not meat cows. Okay, gotcha. They got long hair. Well, yeah, to survive in that weather, I'd have, you know, gotta have a good old coat. Ah, fucking ads. Sorry. In the cord later. Yeah. I was sure she'll turn. Yeah, dude, do what you gotta do. Yeah. I'll be streaming more later this week, so, you know, whenever. Either way, congrats. I don't know if you're hearing any of my congratulations, but congrats either way. I'm really happy for you. Do what you guys gotta do. I appreciate the hanging out either way. Lurk away. I'll be back. Yeah, I watched that, what's it fucking called? Watch that new Barbarian movie that everyone was talking about, a new horror movie. I really don't see what the big to-do with it was. It wasn't a bad movie. There were parts I liked a lot. Part of it's like a 40-minute intro before the movie really starts. It's really weird. It like starts, there's not really a credit sequence or anything. It just kind of starts. And then I would say, yeah, it's like 40 minutes in, it feels like is when the movie really starts. It's really strange. It's a very strange movie. I didn't find it scary at all. I'll say that. A lot of people were saying it was super scary. I didn't really care. I didn't really get that vibe. Some cool, fun physical effects. It was great to see Justin Long acting again. He hasn't really done much in a grip, but it was... Eh. I don't know. I guess I'd give it like a 7 out of 10. Worth a watch. I don't know that I would watch it again. Or even have it on in the background, you know? Like, yeah, I pretty much like spent pretty much my evenings watching movies, playing catch up of films I hadn't seen, and just photoshopping nonstop. But I got to catch up on a lot of good stuff. I saw Nope, and the other one? Run, Sweetheart, Run was really good. I know I watched some other newer movies too. I'm blanking on them right now. Nope was really good. It was kind of a fresh take on like the alien encounter vibe. I'm not a big Jordan Peele fan, but I did enjoy Nope. But I like Aliens too, and I think this is his first like alien-esque movie. And what else did he do? He just did Get Out and Us, I think. I don't know if he... Did he do anything else? Get Out, Us. I think that's it. I saw a trailer. God, my memory is shot. I saw a trailer for apparently M. Night Shyamalan has a new movie coming out too. It's got Dave Bautista in it. Looks interesting. Talk about another dude that we haven't heard from in a while. Maybe his pocketbook is getting a little thin. That's why he's deciding to start making movies again. Been debating on moving my stream setup to my home, because I feel like I'll be able to stream longer and shit like that, maybe later at night and stuff too, if it was set up in my spare office. But I don't know, we'll see about that one. guys could see my dogs too at that point. They would probably do, they'd be very popular. They're pretty adorable. Yeah, I really wanted so badly stream the photoshopping process that I did on all those pics. It's just some cool shit that I was doing with color grading and manipulation and stuff. And yeah, there's just no way. Would not have flown on Twitch at all. Thought about trying to do it on YouTube, but even still, I don't know how well that would have gone. Tricky to see in that shadow at all. Thank you. In case you guys forgot what we actually have been working on this whole time. Thank you. Ripples had episode 142. Jesus, got to be more episodes than that. Yeah, I'm probably going to be wrapping up this leg off stream tomorrow, and then we'll be to molding on Wednesday. But hopefully no more ripples for a while after that. Then it'll just be mold making and eventually casting and painting. Theoretically. Never actually thought I'd say I'm excited to paint, but I'm even over the ripples. But it's the last limb. Well, limbs. I don't know how you'd want to call it. Limbs. I was actually thinking about having Kyle do some of the painting, you know. He showed some interest, so we'll see if he wants to do any of the painting. I have my friend of mine. I don't know if it'll go through, but a friend of mine's working on a custom sculpting tool for me. If it works and it goes well, I actually will be very excited to show it off on stream. You said tools. I'm a tool whore. Dude, I'm a tool whore. Now, I had this idea for a tool. I'm not going to go over it yet because I don't want to give away the surprise. But if it works, it's supposedly getting worked on now. But he's in Chicago. So if my idea works, it'll be really cool. I'll tell you what. I won't fuck around with it before stream. The first time I use it will be on stream. And you guys can see what it is, but I'm actually super excited. I hope it works. I really do. But it's just a theory right now, so. I don't know that it'll, that my idea will work, so. Yeah. I have probably 10 or 15 tools I use pretty regularly. But of those, there's still like my faves, which are going to be three, maybe. And those three are the same three that I always seem to lose the most and get really pissed off when I do. And they're always like hiding in really innocent places that I would never think to look. What makes you an exception? Yeah, if I was sculpting bigger stuff, for sure. That's how I am when I'm sculpting like faces and bodies, big things. But for little shit like this, my big sausage fingers only go so far. This woman I knew when I was in college, she had tiny little fingers, and so she could sculpt really tiny things with her fingers, and she had long fingernails. She would use her fingernails to do sculpting. Always wigged me out, but it worked. Down to 1/8 of an inch. That's fair. And you work in... You, correct me if I'm wrong. All your sculptures, they're life size, right? Milo? Am I wrong? They're all like 1-to-1 scale. Or are they smaller? Yeah, 1-to-1, okay. pretty much life size. Yeah, when you're working on stuff bigger like that, I think I could go a lot further with just using my fingers. I did smaller pieces, but 1-to-1 is the size I really love to work in. Yeah, I don't blame you. It's easier 1-to-1? Hmm. I guess that kind of makes sense. I was recently going through some old pictures from my portfolio, if you can call it that, really just, you know, collection of pictures from back in the day, and God, some of my sculptures were complete garbage. I'm sure I'll look at this thing the same way in a year or two. It's way faster. Yeah, I would agree. Getting in there with your mitts. Yeah, it's way nicer. I feel like you have more control when you get to work with your fingers and move clay around and stuff like that. Yo, what's up, Sticks? Look what the cat coughed up. Yeah, exactly. How things been going? Long time no chat. Yeah, that's not true. Recently, we were catching up on your carpet cleaning escapades. I'm setting myself up to be able to do 3 portraits at the same time. My goal is to be able to do 3 portraits in a month. That'd be dope. If I was only working on that, I could probably do 4 or 5. I need to run my business. Yeah, no, I get you. That makes sense. Working, painting. Yeah, it looks like you're having some fun working on some cool shit over in your area. Whoa. Why, my frames are dropping like crazy. If you guys are hearing this. Yeah, I don't know why all of a sudden my bitrate is in the tank. Oh, Jesus. How long has that been going on? Weird. Has that been going on the whole time? The shitty lag? That's some bullshit. I only just got here for a while. I had a couple of like, really? Damn it. Okay. Figures. Wouldn't be back to a stream without some issues. You know what I mean? Whatever. Yeah, have you been doing all that work on that that iPad sticks? I actually had to just bust out my Wacom over the last week to do all the... I was using my mouse for a while for all the Photoshopping I was working on. Couldn't do it anymore, so I busted out the Wacom and was doing a bunch of photo retouching with it. Took some getting used to, But I got it figured out. Oh, iPad, nice. Are you still using, Fuck. What's it called? I always forget the name of the app. What's the app called that you use? I'm thinking all Adobe names in my head right now. It's not Premiere, it's not Photoshop, it's fucking... You know, I give up. My brain's dead. Procreate. That's it. Okay, cool. Yeah, I like the Van Gogh one, right? It was Van Gogh, right? It was indeed, yeah. I've been so off of Twitch, I'm not even aware. Have you been streaming at all or not really? I haven't streamed at all. Well, I know that feeling. I think it's been like a month and a half was my guess, or close to it since my last stream. Or, you know, something close to that. Okay, it looks like... What is going on with that bit rate, yo? I'm going to have to fuck around with that. I've just been a Discord goblin. It's fine. Discord goblins are good. I don't know if you guys saw, I did post the doll photos I was working on Discord in all of their NSFW glory. Prove that I wasn't just slacking off, you know? And also, since I can't really post them on social media, so... Yeah, they looked fantastic. They were a bitch. It was a long... Dude, one of the houses we stayed at was so cool. Or the house we stayed at. There was an Airbnb when we did that photo shoot. And it was all, like, Victorian'd out. Like, with, like, almost a gothic vibe. Fucking skull chandeliers. Zombie apocalypse metal sliding doors that were, like, automated. So you hit a button and all the windows... on the outside would have this like steel grid work that would come down and then it would like chick, like lock up and stuff. It was awesome. Post them on Twitter, Elon won't care. Well, no, I can't post them yet because we haven't launched it and enough people follow me on my Twitter where if some of the doll people saw, they'd be like, they would know ahead of time. I'll be able to post pictures on social media probably in the next 3 weeks once they officially get launched. Yeah, I'm pretty, you know what's funny is everyone has been freaking out about the whole Elon thing and like I'm pretty indifferent to it. I don't think Twitter's going to change for shit. I think it's pretty much going to still stay a dumpster fire, so. I literally don't think a single thing is going to change. Who knows? Maybe I'll be wrong. Thank you. They were never. Oh my God. You know what's weird? That happens really often with us too. People claiming that we like charged them for something and then didn't give them their money. Like, it's never happened. But, or that we never gave them their product and stuff. But, or sometimes where they swear they placed an order, but we never like charged their card. It's the weirdest shit. It makes no sense. Sending some compassion, indeed. She was never charged. You only charge when... Wait. You guys only charge when the order ships? You don't charge when the order's placed? Hmm. Only when it ships in case it's canceled. Huh. I guess that makes sense. All of our stuff's made to order, so we charge for it all up front, baby. It's only 6:38. I feel like it's bedtime. I hate winter.
Yeah.
I know that feeling. Do you guys do like daylight savings time and stuff like that, right? Or no? It's been snowing for 40. It's already snow. Well, it is November. That's stupid. Yeah, I should have guessed that. Yeah. Damn. Dude, that sucks. The beginning of winter's got to be kind of one of those moments for you guys where you're just like, well, this is it. This is the beginning of the next 6 months of shitty weather. That's how I feel around you for March. I'd say April or May. For living in Vegas, it's like, okay, here's the next 6 months of just absolute heat. It's finally getting nice around here. We're in the 60s now. I like it. Check Discord for snow. It's so pretty. Damn. Hey, at least you work from home. You'd be having to be out and driving in that shit, going to work and whatnot. Ooh, that's true, yeah. Does he have to commute pretty far for work or no? 30 to 45. Oh wow, an hour plus on days like today. Damn, that sucks. I had commutes like that back when I lived in the Midwest, and yeah, as soon as the weather turned to shit, pretty much double the time, you know? Bullshit. I had many a close calls driving through Michigan winters. That shit is no joke. One time I was getting on the freeway and I was on, I think it's called like the acceleration lane, but it's the lane that, you know, merges into traffic on the freeway. And I was turned my turn signal on, started to slowly move over, but I hit a patch of like slush, totally spun me into like a weird fishtail, and I just flipped all the way around. It was no good. And luckily it like parallel parked me on the freeway pointing the other direction, but like off to the side. So I was very lucky in that scenario. It was pretty terrifying. My heart was racing. And actually, that is how I ruined the front end of my first car I had, was a patch of black ice. Totally smashed down through a stop sign into a telephone pole. I still drove that car for like 3 years after that, even though it was pretty much missing its entire front end. He spun out on the highway. Yeah. It's one thing to go into a ditch, which I've done. I've gone into ditches, you know, from just hitting patches of ice and stuff. But it's a different story when, you know, your mishap takes place around an unlimited number of cars just flying past you. Into a snow pile. Yeah, snow is a lot harder than you think it would be. Yeah, the dumb shit you do in small towns. Yeah, for sure. My buddies and I used to go off-roading in every type of car. Every type of car you shouldn't go off-roading in, we would do. We went off-roading in a Lincoln Town Car one time. Lincolns are not designed to go off-roading. Intentionally spin out. Yeah, we did that a couple of times for better and worse results. Sometimes successfully doing it and sometimes ending up in a ditch. Yeah. Well, my bitrate seems to be jumping back and forth, but I think we're going to wrap up the stream either way. We'll be back Wednesday, guys, and we're going to be starting to make molds. So building walls for all the arms and legs of this guy. I'm going to be excited. I hope to see you there. Thanks for everyone coming and hanging out on my first visit back after the month hiatus. So my dad tried to drive through a cornfield Monday day. Guess who got stuck 20 feet away from the corn? Sounds about right. All right, everyone, have a great evening. I will catch up with you all later. Like I said, I'll be back Wednesday. I'll talk to you then. Peace.